chronic disease has gone up and we're struggling with health span and also lifespan. So the discovery of this compound happened with Flipper, believe it or not. Remember Flipper?
It's been discovered in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. It's Flipper, the fabulous dolphin.
Remember that program? If you're my age, you remember the program because he was my hero. And I know he was talking to me. I know. I was little. I was young. I was into marine biology. Jacques Cousteau was my hero. But Flipper was talking to me. And maybe he was. So in this episode, we're going to uncover a compound that's natural that basically beats out metformin and rapamycin. Hands down. So get ready. Is the Visser Podcast. Here we go. It starts off with this veterinary doctor, Dr. Stephanie Van Watson, who was head of the U.S. Navy Marine Mammal Program, where they had big brain dolphins. You can only guess what they were using those for. Anyway, and she was noticing that she had pods of these in Florida, and there were pods in California. And the Florida pods had much less disease, were living longer, and were much healthier. So she started trying to figure out what was the difference. Why did these pods differ so much? These animals were all on all fish diets. And what she came upon in her research was that there was a compound that when this compound was present at higher levels in these mammals, they live healthier and longer. This compound, C15. Yes. This compound is a, believe it or not, an odd chain saturated fat. Yeah, saturated fat. Remember the stuff they told us not to touch, not to eat, stop drinking whole fat milk? Well, it occurs in whole fat milk. And I don't say go drink whole fat milk. You don't want to drink whole fat milk because the proportion of C15 in whole fat milk compared to C16, which is pro-inflammatory, is high. Okay, so it's gonna wash out big time. Okay, so don't do that. But it is in milk, in whole milk or dairy products. So when we look at that, and let's not confuse that with C4, which these dolphins might have been carrying on the water. Just kidding. C15 is what we're looking at. So C15, the consumption is associated with improved general health and longevity since then. Also in humans, not only in these mammals, in humans. So when we uncover this, when we look at C15 and its implications, and I'm going to put it ahead to metformin, which we know. I don't take metformin. I was taking it a while, and I told you why in my other episodes. And the reason is because metformin, in short, real dirty, just limits the oxygen to the mitochondria, making it malfunction, and then in that turn triggers the mTOR, AMPK pathways, okay? I don't want that because I'm training. I'm working out. I'm lifting weights. I want muscle synthesis. I want protein synthesis. And this is gonna basically dampen that. But there's the TAME study going on, long-term study on humans, on longevity with metformin. So when that finally comes out, I might change my mind again. But we'll see. We'll keep you updated on this. So rapamycin was like the thing. Rapamycin, and both of these are prescription drugs. Rapamycin, as there's a PEARL study going on, which is also a longevity study, which will have some, but rapamycin is geroprotective, and which means that it's protecting us against all the diseases that we get with old age. And it's very effective at this. So rapamycin is the king up to now, or up to recently. Now, it's been a long time since omega-3 fatty acids, ALA, EPA have been discovered. Long time. So the C15 in the view of things is very new. And it comes from saturated fat. Yes, Saturated fat. Remember the fat they told us to stay away from? It's seen in whole milk, fatty whole milk. But the problem is, don't go drinking whole milk right now, because next to C15 in whole milk, you also have C16, which is pro-inflammatory, and there's a lot of it in milk. Don't do that. But it gives us a clue. And the other thing is, our microbiome is able to produce some C15, but not at the levels we need. All right? That kind of lays the platform down. When I put this together, I really wanted it to put it against the big boys, metformin, rapamycin. Now, metformin, if you're pre-diabetic, you're diabetic, metformin is your go-to. But if you're healthy, you're working out, you're training, you're keeping your muscles as you age, it's a no-go, okay? Rapamycin stays in the bucket. We have to put C15 against these two and see, where does it fit? Where does it come to? When we look at the health benefits, and I'm going to go straight into the health benefits. Now, as I said before, there's ongoing research. The TAME study is for metformin. That's an ongoing longevity study. If that turns out to have new information, I would change my mind. Rapamycin has the PEARL study that's ongoing, and we're going to look at that, but we already know rapamycin, geroprotective, it's great. Okay, these are both pharmaceuticals. These are both, you can only get them with prescription. C15 is off the shelf. It's a natural product. And that's probably why you're not hearing a lot about it. So let's look at what it does. What does it do? C15. Straight to it, because that's what you want to know. I'm not going to go into too much pathways, although I'm going to put some pictures of pathways here, because the pathways are important. But we're going to see how many cell processes they actually trigger that give us that longevity, that give us that health span. So, one, we're looking for C15, cardiovascular health, decreased risk of heart disease and heart failure, and decreased risk of myocardial infarctions. That is huge. That is huge. Cancer protection. Yes. Proliferative effect on various cancer cell types. Various. I'm going to put a chart up to show you. So, it prevents cancer in a lot of cases. Liver health, remember non-alcoholic liver disease, thing we're seeing a lot of, fatty liver, it reduces fatty liver. Its benefit, it benefits the primary cells system relevant to this non-alcoholic liver disease. Amazing results with liver. It slows aging. How does it do this? It triggers longevity signals. What are those? It triggers mTOR, AMPK, PPARA, alpha, beta, JAK-STAC, DAC-6. Don't worry about these. These are all key indicators that longevity is happening. This slows down the aging. It inhibits mTOR. As we age, mTOR keeps coming up. It goes up. Reason is it's noticing that our body is losing muscle mass. It's more difficult to do protein synthesis for the body. So AMPK goes, the mTOR starts jacking up, going, listen, we need more of this. When that happens, when it does it overly, it's a problem for us. All right. So it brings it back to level. This is huge. And I'll go over this one more time later on. It mitigates COPD and decreases Alzheimer's disease. That's big. That's big. This is C15. It's a fatty acid. C15. So what are the triggers? What's happening? We see autophagy. So we have less zombie cells to no zombie cells. It's anti-inflammatory. It improves our mitochondrial health. Cellular energy goes up. Glucose metabolism, better. So you know what that means with diabetes, pre-diabetes, diabetes 2. Lipid metabolism improved, and anti-cancer. So what markers do we see in our cells when using this? We see a decrease in cholesterol. We see increase in insulin sensitivity. We see a decreased risk of impaired fasting glucose. We see decreased liver enzymes, decreased risk of high blood pressure, decreased BMI, that's your weight, decreased C-reactive protein, inflammation goes down, and adipokines. decreased. So it is really amazing what this natural thing, and we've been looking far. We've been looking far. We've been looking at genetics. We've been looking at the pharmaceutical industry with rapamycin, with metformin, all the way to Easter Island to find this. And here we are. This thing is closer to home than we've ever thought possible. It was right there. But we threw away a while ago. We decided, as the medical community, we decided, listen, this saturated fat, bad for you. Don't touch it. So we threw the whole thing out. We didn't look at specifics within saturated fat. That's where C15 was hiding. Guess what? You're going to ask me, what are you asking me next? You're asking me, how much should I take? The minimum that they've seen in these studies, the minimum, so you need to take more than this, is 5 mg/ml. That's the minimum. You need to take much more. But it gives us an indication, and I'm going to put up a chart, the effects on cells comparatively, so you can see how much more effect this has than, I mean, rapamycin is pretty close. Rapamycin is a pharmaceutical that you have to get a prescription for. It's super expensive. And this beats it, hands down. Metformin doesn't even come close. So yeah, is this exciting? This is super exciting. And really, listen, I've had a lot of comments to make my videos a little shorter. And so that's what I'm trying. And in order to make them shorter, I got to cut some corners. So these are the corners I cut in really explaining the backstory. But you see the research papers, you see the pictures that I've put up with the research. You can go there. You can get all the research you want on C15 if you're interested, and you should be interested, because this is the next molecule. And let me tell you, anything beating this, I'll bring it up. It'll be on my episode right away. But as of now, nothing's beating this. So get to it. Remember, hang with me. You're going to be healthier and you're going to live longer. Get your friends involved. Get people to join the podcast. Subscribe, ring the bell notification. Do the things. Let's grow the channel. Thank you. See you next time.